How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. In a surprising move, the Lakers have traded Danny Green and their 2020 first round pick for Dennis Schroder. The trade will be finalized after the NBA draft when they can officially trade the player they draft to the Thunder, but we'll talk about who I believe won the trade, what moves they'll be looking to make next, and other rumors regarding Rajon Rondo and Kentavious Caldwell Pope. But we'll begin by talking about the trade for Dennis Schroder and how the current team and the salary cap is now looking. After trading Danny Green in their first round draft pick for Schroder, their only current players under contract through 2020-2021 are Dennis Schroder, Alex Caruso, Quinn Cook, Talen Horton Tucker, and LeBron James. You could hypothetically include Anthony Davis too, as he will be returning with a new contract very soon, but without him, that is what the current team will look like going into free agency. And what does Schroder provide for the team? A lot, actually. He arguably had the best year of his career while playing for the Thunder in 2019-2020 and showed improvement in nearly every area of his game. And most notably, he greatly improved as a shooter and was a much more efficient player all around compared to prior years. He shot nearly 47% from the field as a point guard, which is very good, and he shot 38.5% from the three-point line. Both of those are the best numbers of his career so far, and he has a very good chance to replicate them, or at the very least come close to them after now joining a Laker team that is even better than the team he was already on. Another very noteworthy thing to add about how well Schroder played was that he did it while coming off the bench. Not many players can transition as effectively to coming off the bench and still being as productive, if not more productive than before, like Schroder has. But he is that kind of player who gives a big spark off the bench and can come in and give your team 20 to 30 points in any given game, and he does that all while being a good playmaker as well. Schroder has always been a pretty good playmaker, but even while coming off the bench and playing a lot of shooting guard next to Chris Paul while on the Thunder, he still had an assist average of 4 a game, and that is very important for a Laker team that may not be able to retain Rajon Rondo. As it is being widely reported that the Lakers traded for Schroder with the belief that Rondo won't be returning to the team, and unfortunate as that would be if they aren't able to retain Rondo, Schroder was very likely one of the best possible replacements they could have found for him. Schroder can already fill in Rondo's bench role, and probably even play better than him during the regular season too. Schroder is much younger and won't be trying to conserve his energy only for the playoffs. And although he isn't the defender that playoff Rondo is, he did notably improve quite a bit as a defender in recent years. A few years ago, Schroder was considered one of the worst defensive point guards in the entire league, but now, Schroder has changed that and has put a lot more effort into defending. For example, he had a defensive rating of 100.3 in 2018-2019, which is very good. The lower the rating, the better, when looking at defensive rating, and he actually had a better rating than other noteworthy defenders like Jrue Holiday and Victor Oladipo that year. And then in 2019-2020, he had another good rating of 103.0. Even though defending can be hard to rank by numbers alone, they do show how much he has improved as a defender, and how much more effort he has put into it as well. Which is huge when considering the team he has been traded to puts defending as a higher priority than nearly anything else when it comes to their role players. I think he'll be able to fit right into the way the team plays, and he'll even have a chance of helping to improve their defense right away. Overall, I'd be very happy if I were the Lakers with their trade for Dennis Schroder. He has the ability to improve their team in every area, and is a great replacement for Rondo if he doesn't actually return to the team. And with Avery Bradley also being a question mark, it made this trade even better for them. And for the Thunder, it provided them with yet another draft pick that they can use to either start the rebuild or potentially use in a trade. The Thunder are really showing every team the correct way to rebuild right now, in my opinion. They really haven't wasted any time or any moves. Even with acquiring Chris Paul, they gained a ton of draft picks and provided their best young player with a perfect mentor for a year as well. The Thunder are well on their way to being an upcoming team in only a couple of years, and if they draft and develop their young players correctly, they could be well on their way to creating another dynasty like they did with Kevin Durant and Russell Westbrook in the past. And while I do believe the Lakers won the trade, it wasn't by as much as some people are making it out to be. The Thunder wanted to trade Schroder to free up more minutes for their young players, and Schroder is only under contract through this year, so they couldn't expect a huge return for him anyway. By trading for him now, they saved themselves from potentially losing him in the future for nothing, or from the possibility of him getting hurt and them not being able to trade him in the middle of the year because of it. This trade worked out perfectly for both teams who have very different goals, with the Lakers being in win-now mode and the Thunder with a mindset of being able to win in 2 to 3 years from now. Overall, I love this trade for the Laker team, and I believe it was great for them, but kudos for the Thunder for being willing to go all in on the rebuild right now too. But we also have to consider what the Lakers gave up by trading Danny Green. Even though he had an underwhelming year and wasn't able to be the three-point shooter that they wanted, he was still a vital part of their team. He isn't the individual defender that he used to be, but he was still a very good team defender and a good locker room guy. They'll need to find a replacement for him, and likely one for cheap too. The rumored name that came out after the trade news broke out was Wesley Matthews, and I believe he would be a good target, but he isn't an ideal replacement for Danny Green in my opinion. If anything, I think he'd be a good replacement for Caldwell Pope if he doesn't return to the team. And I say that because while Matthews is a good 3-point shooter and a pretty good defender yet, he is only 6'4". He wouldn't be the guy they need to defend bigger wing players. He could fill in for Caldwell Pope in defending guards and smaller wing players, but he is a bit too short to defend guys that play often like Kawhi Leonard, Paul George, and Devin Booker for example. And I think I'll make a separate video on players I believe the team should target to replace Danny Green, but one good wing defender I believe they need to have as a high priority right now is Justin Holiday. Holiday is the same height as Danny Green, but younger and more mobile, with longer arms too. Holiday is 31 and is a very underrated player, and because of it, he could be a great target for the team to replace Danny Green. And most importantly, they could likely bring in both Holiday and Matthews as well. I believe Holiday won't demand much more than around $5 million in free agency, and I think Matthews could likely be brought in with a veteran minimum contract. These two would be great backup plans to Danny Green and Caldwell Pope if the team can't work out a deal with him. And that leads us to our final topic, which is about Caldwell Pope and Rajon Rondo, both rumored to be looking at signing with other teams. It sounds like they both are looking for a pay increase, with that being very likely of Caldwell Pope in particular. He is only 27 years old, and although he isn't coming off a career year, being a key role player on a championship team can help any player get paid, and that is what it seems like he is looking for, but he likely doesn't have many options. The only other teams who could offer him a contract that might be more attractive to him than the Lakers offer are non-contending teams like Atlanta, Detroit, and the Knicks. Those are really the only other teams with available money to offer in free agency this year, so if he were to leave for more money, that would mean likely joining a bad team, because every other contending team could only offer him the full mid-level exception at most, which isn't as much as the Lakers could offer with them owning his bird rights. The only problem is that he could be asking for a lot more than the team wants to offer, and that is a problem because even though they could realistically give him a big pay increase, the team is trying to stay under the luxury tax apron to be able to use their full mid-level exception on a player maybe like Danilo Gallinari or Serge Ibaka for example, because if they go over the luxury tax apron set at $139 million again, their mid-level exception goes from being worth around $10 million a year to only $7 million a year, and that may not be enough to attract a guy like Gallinari or Ibaka. That same issue applies to Rondo. Even though the team would love to have him back, they can't afford to give everyone a big pay increase and still hope to improve the team. And that is even more true now because Avery Bradley reportedly will opt out of his player option too in search of more money. Overall, it is a tough situation for the team with wanting to bring back the players to help bring the championship back to LA, but they can't afford to pay everyone. Hard choices are going to need to be made, but the team is in good hands with Rob Pelinka, who made really good moves to fill up the team last year after trading for Anthony Davis, where they also had very little money to work with. I have a lot of trust in him, and I believe he not only has a plan A and a plan B, but a plan C and D to go along with it. It would be hard to lose Rondo and Caldwell Pope, but there are always good backup plans. But what do you guys think? Who do you think would be a good potential backup plan for Danny Green and maybe Caldwell Pope, Rondo, and Avery Bradley as well? I think the team made a great move by trading for Schroder and being prepared for Rondo leaving, but what other players would you like to see the team bring in? Let me know by commenting down below and we can talk about it there. But that'll do it for this video. Thank you to everyone who watched until the end. And if you enjoyed, please remember to drop a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And as always, thank you for watching.